the people over on the team that is developing the Skype program, you know, that calling program everyone used to use for content creation and video chatting and messaging and things like that, they've been working behind the scenes developing new tools for content creators. I previously showed in the last video how you could use this new Skype update to send NDI feeds of people in video calls to OBS or other live streaming programs to create a really cool podcast or interview format with virtually lag-free and lossless recording setups, which was pretty freaking cool. Well, in this video, I'm going to show you a built-in tool that they have, which is a dedicated recorder for Skype, something that we've always had to use third-party tools for or bots, and things always stopped working, and it was really frustrating because it seemed like the easiest way to record interviews or podcasts or dual commentaries, collaborations would be a form of recording a Skype call back in the day, and there was never an easy option, and they now have a built-in option. So we're going to be checking it out, but this is in a beta or preview version of Skype, typically reserved for people in the Windows Insider build. I will have a link to the download for the preview version in the description down below. This is, again, it's a preview. They're looking for feedback. It's not fully out yet. There may be some bugs, whatever. Test it. It's not fully ready yet, but it's still something I want to share with you and showcase because it is really neat. Let's flip over to the desktop and check it out. Plex is the media streaming app that beautifully organizes your media collections and lets you securely access them on all your screens, now with live TV viewing and DVR. Click the link in the video description to learn more. Alright, so I have started a Skype call with myself over on the other computer. I don't know why it says poor network connection. I'm on a gigabit fiber line and we're on the same network, not that that actually affects anything, but Skype still has network connection issues somehow, I guess. So I've started a video call with myself here, and you have a couple things you can do. You have your normal settings where you could go in and enable the NDI feed, as I showed before. You can take a snapshot, so you can just take a picture of both of your cameras at once, which is kind of cool. And then over here under the plus icon, you have an option to start recording. And what that is going to do, it is it's going to bring in a cloud Skype contact. It starts recording the Skype call, and it will record your video and your audio, or just your audio. If you don't have webcams going, it'll record video from both sides. I actually have the wrong webcam here because I was using it for OBS. So now I can sit here and change it so I can showcase it. Cam link. Okay, good to go. I am now sending a feed from both of us to the Skype call, and it will record. So the whole time you're sitting there chatting, yada, yada. How was your day? My day was great. Let's do an interview. Okay, do you want the job? Do you have anything to say about this damning news story about you? Oh, I didn't do it. It wasn't me. Okay, Skype call done. When you hit end, it's going to take a minute, and then it's going to send you a recording of that Skype call and an option to download it, which is really freaking neat. There we go. It's already here. Recordings are available for 30 days. They're stored up in the cloud, which if you don't like it, sorry, it's just an option. You can either play the video from here, which it's going to start playing, and if I fast forward a bit, you can see, okay, I have both of our video go. Oh, and then I set up my video, and now we have both videos going. It does crop your view a bit, so you will want to check on framing based on the call view. You can see that looks more like the call view. Frame rate is amazing. You can see that's not 60 FPS or even 30 FPS necessarily, but for its purpose, it's kind of cool. And if you wish to download it, you can just say it, save to downloads, save as. You can forward it to someone else, or you can remove it. So I'm going to just hit save to downloads. It's downloading the video. And once it's done, we will have file saved. And I can even click where it said file saved and start viewing the video. It's that easy. That easy. So I know mass opinions on Skype can go one way or the other, but I do think this feature is really cool. It's something I've wanted in Skype for, what, a decade now? And I'm really glad to see it enabled. And if I just need to do a quick recording call that I don't need like super high quality for, this was probably the option I'm going to go with because it's just a quick and dirty record of what you have and the file is delivered. And if I pull it up from my downloads here, video.mp4, it is a 1080p file, 15 frames per second and about 1 megabit per second. So nothing amazing, but nothing terrible either. And that's okay. So hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, again, check out the Skype preview, download link in the description down below. Hit the like button if you enjoyed, like I just said, subscribe for more tech education, and I will see you in the next video.